Sports now, Filipino pole vaulter EJ Obiena secures a spot in the 2024 Summer Olympics in Paris. That's after he cleared the qualification standard of 5.82 meters at the Bauhaus Gallen meet in Sweden. He then proceeded to attempt clearing 5.95 meters, but he failed after three times. He finished second in the contest after Sweden's Armand Duplantis. This feat makes Obiena the first Filipino to clinch a spot at the Paris Games.
James Aranas and Joan Chua captured the 2023 World Cup of Pool title after winning a title joust against Germany in nine-ball doubles. Aranas and Chua are the first unseeded pair to have ever won the prestigious tournament. The duo defeated Spain, Chinese Taipei, and Austria before besting Germany 11-7. Now, their victory gives the Philippines the most title wins in the World Cup of Pool with four crowns in total. They joined the company of billiards legends Efren Bata Reyes and Francisco Django Bustamante.
So with Elon Musk, the Twitter owner announced the social media platform will temporarily limit the number of tweets its users can read per day. The move, Musk says, is meant to discourage extreme levels of data scrapping and system manipulation. Verified accounts are limited to viewing 10,000 posts per day, while unverified users can only read 1,000 posts per day, while new verified users are limited to just 500 posts.
The Philippine Commission on Audit says the office of the vice president established satellite offices without following procedures mandated by the government procurement law. State auditors noted in their 2022 report the OVP failed to ensure government resources were utilized as intended and prevented from loss. The office of Vice President Sara Duterte purchased property and equipment worth over 660,000 pesos for the construction of nine satellite offices across the country. These purchases were made using the cash of OVP officers, which were subsequently paid through reimbursement. Meanwhile, the OVP assured the audit team their future transactions would be processed following the guidelines of the procurement law.
Philippine Housing Secretary Jerry Acuzar vows to deliver around 100,000 houses by 2024. This is on top of the 1.3 million units across 20 projects that are already under construction. Acuzar says the government is still looking for idle public land that can be converted into housing settlements. By next year, the housing chief believes the government can start 30 more housing projects. The Marcos administration aims to build 1 million houses annually to address the country's housing backlog of 6.5 million units.
Hindi ganun kabilis gumawa ng projects eh. Siyempre, gagawa ng plano, kukuha ng lupa. Tapos ang pinakamabigat dyan, bidding. Pag local government property. Pag binid mo yan, maabot ng 6 na buwan eh. Yung documentation. Kaya yun, medyo doon tumatagal. Kaya nga, ang ating gobyerno nag-iisip ng paraan paano mapabilis, lalo yung bidding process.
Other news, a sugary industry leader calls out the Philippine finance chief over the proposed higher tax on junk food and sweetened drinks. Manuel Lamata of the United Sugar Producers Federation accused Secretary Benjamin Diokno of favoring manufacturers over farmers in pushing for the move. Lamata also says they wrote to President Marcos to voice their opposition to the proposal.
For one, I want to make it very clear to the public, to us consuming public, the consumers of the Philippines. These industrials are not farmers, that's number one. They are not consumers and they are not traders. They are manufacturers.
Okay.
They buy sugar wherever they can buy, as cheap as they could, convert it to sodas, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, Tetra Pak, and sell it to us consumers. Hmm. So who are they favoring? Who is Diokno favoring here? The manufacturer. There's no question about that. He doesn't like us, the farmers.